Learn how to use dependency injection in Azure Functions in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. When you use the dependency injection pattern, you make it easy for classes to receive an instance of a service and use it without having to instantiate it. This makes your code more readable and enables you to reuse services easier. Let's see how that works in Azure Functions. I'll create a function in Visual Studio, and you can use VS Code as well. Okay, I'll leave the name of it and the location. And I'll use the HTTP trigger. This starts the function when I request its URL. Okay, create the project. And here it is. A standard .NET Azure Function project. Let's see. To demonstrate dependency injection, I'll add some classes in a folder here. So here I'll paste in these files. This is an interface called iTipService, which I use for dependency injection. It only has one method in it, and that is implemented in here, the tipService. The getTip method returns a URL to a random post of the Azure Tips and Tricks website. All right, now to inject this service into my application, I need something else, a startup class. This runs when the function app starts up. It inherits from the function startup class, and you can only have one startup class in your function app. In here, I inject an HTTP client service, and here I inject the tip service using the interface. This is what dependency injection looks like, and it needs the Microsoft.extensions.dependency-injection reference. All right, let's make this work. I need to install the Microsoft.azure.functions.extensions package. All right, that should be that. And I need to add another NuGet package. Let's go take a look. I need the Microsoft.extensions.http package. This contains the HTTP client that we will use in the function. Okay, that's it. And let's go back. All right, this will work. Let's look at the function. I'll replace all of the code with something else. Here we go. Okay. Let's see, I'm missing a reference. So for this HTTP client, I need to add this one. Okay, that seemed to work. So this function class has a constructor, and it uses that to get an HTTP client factory and an iTip service injected into it. These are fully instantiated and ready to be used. That is the beauty of dependency injection. And further down here in the function method, I first use the tip service to get a URL. This will point to a post on the Tips and Tricks website. I retrieve the URL with the HTTP client and examine the response. If it can find the page of the URL, it returns a redirect response, which should point the browser to the Tips and Tricks website. Let's run the function to see if that works. As it is an HTTP triggered function, I need to use this URL. Okay, let's paste that in a browser. And yep, it redirects me to the Azure Tips and Tricks website. Let me try that again to see if it really is random. And there it is, another post. Cool! Dependency injection makes code easier to read and to reuse. You can use it in .NET Azure Functions by implementing a startup class that uses the function startup class. Go and check it out.